talking to stop and the fighting to start, this should be good. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, former world champion Johnny Nelson.
Exaction. Exaction night.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. You can tell both of these fighters are exuding confidence. And we're off and running between these two really accomplished fighters. Let's see how they come out. They both want the knockout. Counter left. Watch that jab. You don't want to go tit for tat in there in this fight. The bravery being shown here is just incredible. Perfect counter shot. This fight a little bit closer than I think a lot of people thought. He missed that jab. Puncher's gonna wait for you to move first, and then we'll strike like a snake. Keep an eye on this guy.
The reaction is second to none. It's the blink of an eye, and then waiting for any little twitch you do. So you've got to fight a counter punch is smart.
Good counter punch. That left counter was perfectly timed. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Sweet music to his ears.
Okay, needs a knockout without a doubt. Needs to go out there and think, right, you know what? Next round.
Here we go. Round two. Who's going to land the first big shot? Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's been hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Because he's gonna try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are bunny. He knows your legs are twisted. Be sharp.
Ending that left counter punch. He blocks that jab. Nice exchange here from both men. To score with that left hook. I can't believe we're only halfway through the round. You've got to find a way to get around that reach advantage.
Very smart, very sharp. This is the fit young man style that he's got to get inside that long reach. Not many fighters can do that.
Beautiful counter shot. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Is down big time on the scores.
The bell, sometimes it couldn't be.
Let's get it started in round three. So the fight will continue. How do they turn things around?
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to bluff it. They've got to come at you now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab. Rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then put the pressure on.
This offensive just clean that left hand. The typical big man, little man argument. He's got to be quicker. He's got to move a lot to win this fight.
The plan is to try and change that game plan. Get him angry. Get him frustrated. Make him deviate away from the plan.
It's the typical big man, little man argument. He's got to be quicker. He's got to move a lot to win this fight. Real good back and forth between these two fighters. He blocks the jab. These two fighters are made for one another. Punching for both these athletes. Nice counter shot. Another scoring shot there. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. Well, he is glad to have heard that bell.
Wow, you know, I've been in fights like that. When you're thinking, come on, bro, ring away. You walk back to the corner like you've just seen the sun.
Great work. I love that. I love that. That jab's slick.
There's the bell to start round four. So not the best round, but let's see if they can turn it around here. And negatives in the heavyweight division are the same. You can win the fight with one punch, and you can lose the fight in one punch.
We've got a couple of big units here. So I'm expecting you're going to have excitement. You're going to have drama, because when these guys slow down, that's going to punch you.
Elbows tucked into the chest so we can avoid the pain of those body shots. But come on, that leaves more opportunities for headshots. Threw the hook, didn't land. Halfway through the round. Don't let this fighter's speed fool you. There's some method to the madness. These are precision shots, and they're coming at lightning speed.
So you're getting in there with somebody that's so fast, you're prepared to take a lick it, because you're gonna get some before you get close.
Very competitive round with 10 seconds left. What would you tell this guy he's got to do? On to the fifth we go. Well, they got battered last round. How do they turn their fortunes around? Both won a highlight reel knockout. This is a high-octane battle. Ah. back to life now, starting to punches. Got someone with the hand speed that this fighter possesses. How do you deal with it?
This can be so frustrating when you're in such a fast sprinter. Fast fighter can throw 3-4 shot combinations before you even let one off. That creates frustration, and that's when it gets hard.
We're at the halfway point of this round, and both of these fighters have had their moments. Still can go either way. Believe what we are seeing. Good one. Neither man really defending himself. This round still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make doesn't put it on him. That's what he's gonna try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
This fighter is not interested in throwing one shot at a time. They throw combinations and they throw them non-stop.
Never seen a fighter so fast in my life. How do you deal with this? You gotta hope.
I can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. And there's not a lot separating these two. He misses with that jab. And he misses with that jab. You hear people talk about a boxer's chin. Do they have a good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions that are being answered here tonight.
Because you've got a good chin doesn't mean you've got leather skin. It means you can still get caught. So you've got to go for this point there. It's over the eyebrow, the cheekbone. You've just got to try and cut them skin and go for speed.
This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. Soon enough for this guy.
Wow, it's like two different leagues.
On top of him. Don't let him get back his fight. Don't let him get that confidence. He's gonna be strong. Yes, I like that round. Good round. You feel good? Good man.
Here we go. It's round 7. Not the start that they wanted, but let's see what they can do in this round. Showing exceptional chins, by the way. His jab just got blocked. About punches and bunches, that's the mantra for this fighter with that exceptional hand speed.
Some fighters are just gifted. Gifted with such hand speed, footwork, movement. They are gifted. They are the chosen few.
We're at the halfway point of this round. Both of these fighters have had their moments. Still could go either way. He just misses with that jab. Good punch. Wolfman, just a moment. Scorecards are going to be all over the place. Well, this is the time that the... There's the bell to start round eight. After that round, something has got to change. Is no matter how much speed you've got, timing beats speed.
You've got to ruffle their feathers, Todd. You cannot let them get comfortable, drag them, get them complaining to the referee. Because somebody with excellent foot speed and excellent power gets into the rhythm, the fight is over.
You'd like to see more jabs. They call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
This is when you get in the ring feeling like you're King Kong, because you know you've got a chin that is not going to get dented.
Do you believe what we are seeing? Now, go either way, 10 seconds to go. The game plan does not seem to be working here. What's he have to do differently? Both fighters starting to get tired as we start round nine. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get sucked in. Make him fight. Your fight. Hold him. Tie him up. Just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Right punch. One of the best attributes to have in boxing has nothing to do with boxing. It's how well you can take a punch to the face.
Work the body, frustrate them, take the mind off the chin, take the mind off protecting everything around that. Work the body, use tactics. Sometimes it's all right to actually have a boxer fight and beat them on points.
What a round so far as we've reached the halfway. No power in those punches. You couldn't write a script like this. This is like Rocky versus Apollo. These two fighters are made for one another. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Hey! Talk about a one-sided 3 minutes. We just saw it.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
Hey, shut it. Come on, look across at him. Look at him.
There's the bell for round 10. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter. He continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. You are not fit. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be, having second thoughts in the ring.
Blocks the hook. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. And both of these fighters know the round is still up for grabs. Nice job by him to block that jab. We've seen in the past from this fighter, they don't seem concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment.
That power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
Still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Well, it's no secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store. And there's the bell for round 11. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. People in the division hit like them. Been set back for just a moment. That left leg. Safe to say, one of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
Let me explain to you about a fast fighter that's got hand speed and fingers. They're relaxed. They're confident. They know they just have the quick burst. Boom! In a split second, they've let four shots go. Their footwork has got them out of the way. And these guys, they're relaxed. That's why they can maintain this all the way through a fight.
Halfway through the round, and I don't know who's got the advantage. Great stuff. Catastrophe there. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. We'll see how much endurance these two fighters have.
That's when you talk about championship
On to the 12th. Not sure these two fighters can keep up the pace we saw last round, but you know they're going to try.
What were they doing that round? Are they trying to get an early night? That's a lot of energy burst. They did six rounds in one. They're going to be absolutely shattered.
Was is 1 minute enough time for them to recover after what we saw last. Back and forth they go. Power puncher, you're not as concerned with how many punches you throw, it's about how many you land and how hard they are.
It's the one who draws first blood, Todd. That's what you've got to look at. If you can hit and you know you're in there with a banger, you've got to be done here. You've got to be.
Oh, and Tyson Fury just got rocked. This could be it. Tyson Fury, one of the great heavyweight champions. Disaster averted, it seems. We continue on. And then step back for just a moment. One punch could change everything in this battle. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. No surprise as we get a unanimous decision there.
Unanimous? You know what? Smart. Smarts, that is. A total change of styles to make sure they got it. Had every round in the bag, there was no argument, no discussion, no mistake. It was so obvious.
What they thought this was, what? But I come through smoking. Yeah. Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, but the squad gets scolded.
Right.
War with the Lord, not an omen. Still might have to grill a brother like Foreman. When my dogs start rioting, leaves will be falling off trees. You'd think that it's autumn. Yo, I can't stand these rap boys. Feel to eliminate all.
That's right.
I'm trying to raise this stack, boy, so tall that it might fall. Top striker, man, I lick off the goal, so anything I set, I achieve and more. Blah. Soon bring the man them on some kind of tour. Yeah. Enough liquor bottles in my rider report. I don't know why they would step to the team, and I'll send man airborne like Fly B. Come like this as some sci-fi scene when I lace this magic on these type of beats. Woo. I don't want to hear no talk from a dweeb. You don't respect me if you don't pay my fees.
True.
If you don't respect me, then please better back out the way of this heat. I don't know what they thought this was,
what?
But I come through smoking.
Yeah.
Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, with the squad get scolded.
Right.
War with the Lord, not an omen. Still might have to grill a brother like Foreman. When my dogs start rioting, leaves will be falling off trees. You'd think that it's autumn.
Blah.
I don't know what they thought this was, but I come through smoking.
Yeah.
Smooth criminal like Pounds just told them, with the squad get scolded.
Right.
War with the Lord, not an omen. Still might have to grill a brother like Foreman. When my dogs start rioting, leaves will be falling off trees. You'd think that it's autumn. Yo. Step to the place where my jeers are with all nine and I'm on a mad one.
Maddest.
I don't want no attention from that gyal if she ain't a bad one.
Baddest.
Man try tell me the 3-5 come too stinky, it's Cali that packs from.
Cali.
And if I go broke, N95's and nightclubs slapped on.
Ballies.
Soon put chef on the map, son, don't pop with too many brothers, they cap enough.
Yeah.
Dog, I don't care about the past, act bad in the present and you can get wrapped up.
Wrapped.
I don't deal with pests, man got no fertilizer for them. Go on then, run up your mouth yet again, Joe get sent all the way up like Rem.
That's right.
Gypsy King himself. He is the... momentum going. Nice job landing with that right hand count.
Number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room.
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room.
Boom. Came in clean, though, without a broom.
There ain't no room.
Still here, still not been moved. I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Straight in, more pain, so more gaining. Here I came in, guns blazing, at raving. You get weighed in, been training, sick of waiting. Some failing, not plain sailing, entertaining. Check the ratings, let me out, I don't wanna be caged in. Yeah, I'm ready, who's next up? Pay attention now, yeah, your best luck. I like to warm up like a few jabs, and then I hit hard like a left hook. My style's unique, not textbook. Step to me, you get yourself messed up. Win or lose, still here, still not been moved. I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Only one, number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room.
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room.
Boom. Came in clean, though, without a room.
There ain't no room.
Still here, still not been moved. I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Only one, number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room.
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room.
Boom. Came in clean, though, without a room.
There ain't no room.
Still here, still not been moved. I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Who wants it? For anybody, I got this. They say you can learn from your losses, but victory tastes sweet like chocolates. Top of the game, you can't top this. Permanent sauce, never lost it. You came in the game and you flopped it. I came in the game and I bossed it. That's why me and you are different. I'm ahead, you lot are in the distance. Stay persistent and consistent. I'm the king now, this is my kingdom. Ready for takeoff, watch how I lift them. Take shots, it's rare that I miss them.
Boom.
Win or lose, still here, still not been moved. I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Only one, number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room.
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room.
Boom. Without a room,
there ain't.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is go time. My name is Todd Grisham. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
Looking forward to this one, Todd.
It's time for our tale of the tape. And yes, he is the greatest, Muhammad Ali. 6'3" tall, the best to ever do it. And his opponent, Eddie the Beast. Thousands of fans here in attendance tonight. And we're underway in round one. Kick punch scores. With the right counter. He gets out of the way of that left hand. Both men step back for just a moment. Halfway through the round, and man, these two are going at it. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Now, Smith step back in just a moment. He just misses with that big right hand. No stamina, no injury, but still throwing punches. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this. Pretty dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter, and the cornerman's got to put a firecracker on that fighter to get out there and get the job done.
Good round. You feel good?
Good man. Here we go. Round two. Who's going to land the first big shot? Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Fighter told us yesterday, if he doesn't win by knockout, he doesn't consider it a real victory. That's the mentality he has.
Sluggers just want to mow you down. They want to walk straight through as though you do not exist. You've got to be fit for this one.
Round here so far. It's the typical big man, little man argument. He's got to be quicker. He's got to move a lot to win this fight.
If you're in there with a guy so big in front of you, you've got to be smart. You've got to use your smart and use that skill. This is what you've prepared for. You've got to negate that jab, let it rise past you, and push his own weight on him.
He parries away that left hook. With that. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. As bad as boxing judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round.
As long as they don't get complacent.
There's the bell for round three. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. As it is in most heavyweight fights, don't blink, because one big shot and this thing could be over.
Because they're so big, because they can punch, because they've got the weight behind them, they may not be connecting, but trust me, when they connect, that's when this fight sets on fire, because someone's going to get hurt and someone's going to react.
Perfect punch. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there would be some more action here. Pretty much and Steven. One of these fighters is starting to run out of gas. What do you do as a fighter when you just don't have the energy?
What can they change? They can change their attitude. They can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round. Because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again, and the fight will be over.
Shots, even if they land, are going to do no damage. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. you, all three judges here are going to give that round to you-know-who.
Dominic.
Here we go to the fourth round. That round was complete domination. Let's see if we can shake things up here in this round.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you're doing because you win it hands down.
Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here. In the early rounds of a fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power, and I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
Todd, you know what? Sometimes when a bell in the ring, with fights like that, and you punch them, you just want to run. You want that spaceship to kind of lift you out there because you think, what the hell am I going to do now?
It's been a best-of-four contest so far, no doubt about it. He misses with that jab. Here we're gonna see a jab from these two. Round with 10 seconds to go. That was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance.
I seriously hope the judge.
Here we go in round five. Who's going to land the first big shot? Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see us here in the next one. Famous in movies, the training scenes, the gym work. That's what it all boils down to. Who's going to have more endurance?
What can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they help to knock them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and relax. Because you know what you can do in the gym. You can do it at the back. You've got to relax.
Just missed with that big right hand. Which one of these athletes is going to say, I can't take it anymore? We're at the halfway point of this round, and both of these fighters have had their moments. Still could go either way. Tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter, and the cornerman's got to be so important now.
Here we go in the sixth round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. This fighter has determined that they can walk through any punches that their opponent throws, and that's a very confident spot to be in.
What a gift. What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can walk through anything and everything. When you let these shots go and it's just bouncing off and they're walking you down, it's so demoralizing. It absolutely breaks your heart. What else can you do?
And the world's strongest man is staggered. The beast, Eddie Hall, is down. So there you have it. It is official now, and that is not the way anyone wanted this fight to end.
No complaints there at all. The crowd agree. I agree. The ref knew exactly what he was doing. So you know what? Great shout. I look forward to fight number two.
Lighteth every man and woman that cometh into this continent, into this world of America today.
And not a bad day for a fight here live at the Empire Fight Camp. And watching this live with me is Johnny Nelson.
Todd, always a pleasure to work with you. Always a pleasure.
And now it's time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. And his opponent, Deontay Wilder. He is the bronze bomber. 6'7" tall with that. The greatest of all time, the Bronze Bomber, fighting out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama, the former heavyweight champion of the world.
Todd, can you spot the reach difference? Can you spot it? Look at that.
And now for the official for a boxing match, but we certainly do today as we fight under the sun. Listen, when you fight some defending themselves.
Just to win for some time, they need to feel the blood, the crunch. They need to get that win.
Beautiful counter shot. This round can go either way with 10 seconds to go. Well, we know they've got the advantage so far, but how does this match get turned around?
Dominance. Without a doubt, Meg looks so, so easy.
There's the bell for round two. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Reach advantage, let's see if he uses it.
Very smart, very sharp. This is a fit young man's style that he's got to get inside that long loop. Not many fighters can do that.
He's fighting a little bit closer than I think a lot of people thought. He just missed that left jab. Judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that one.
I see if they don't get complacent.
Here's the bell to start round three. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
Can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they hold them to knock them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and relax. Because you know what you can do in the gym, you can do it in the first round. You've got to relax.
Wait for the round. I'm not sure if he's winning it. Thank you. now with 10 seconds to go. I promise you, all three judges here are going to give that round to you-know-who.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
There's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Because this fighter won't stay down. How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating.
Just depends on how confident you are in the fight. It's a good start to the round for this guy. Shake off the cobwebs after a disastrous last round.
Do you look, Master, you're coming back from that? That's near on impossible, because your head must be all over the place. Your legs are feeling like jelly. What can they tell you in the corner? All they can do is wake you up. They can't even go into game plan.
You're not as concerned with how many punches you throw as about how many you land and how hard they are.
Todd, do you know one of these guys can knock you out with a simple jab? They're that powerful.
Nice exchange here from both men. For this fighter with that exceptional hand speed.
You've got to read this anticipation. You've got to wait. You've just got to throw caution to the wind. And just hope. You're never going to know where the shots are coming from. You've just got to put them in the gap.
Very competitive round.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as a fighter, and the corner has got a question.
Start the six. after a really strong round. Let's see if they can finish the job.
Good. My motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything worked. Wait for the reaction. I tell you, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here. Certainly an aggressive fighter, but that doesn't always mean success. How many times have you seen a fighter chase a superior athlete around the ring and just get picked apart, even though they were the one pushing the tempo?
How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What you do is fight a fiery fight. You have a good and bad because that's where they're comfortable.
Output, thought there might be more action here. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Well, there was no doubt about who won that round.
Dominance, without a doubt, made it look so, so easy.
Feel each other out, test each other's power, and I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
Todd, you know what? Sometimes when I'm going in with something like that, I'll punch them. You just want to win. You want that space to come and lift you up there because you think, what the hell am I going to do now?
opponent by any means. But they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
It's only courageous when you're getting in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've got to use brain.
Shift.
uppercut. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. It's no secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute...
There's the bell to start round 11. Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here. Between being the aggressor and the
Deontay Wilder locked right now. He's in some serious trouble.
Well, he's got him right where he wants him. Can he put him away? No, we don't see a knockdown. We know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one.
Without a doubt, Meg looks.
He thought he would have made it to 12. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last second. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. To have in boxing has nothing to do with boxing. It's power. You can take a punch to the face.
I've seen some fighters with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer. They are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like the ice. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. And this is the danger.
Just like that, this fight is over. We were expecting it to go the distance, but he had other ideas. A knockout win. Congratulations.
Accuracy. Power. Punch. Perfect. That was great.
Champion till I die. Every morning, every night, boy, I gotta look alive. Now you. Yeah. You know who's up in the house tonight. The champions are back in your town. Feel the stands and make them shout tonight. The champions about to get down. You know who's up in the house tonight. The champions are back in your town. Feel the stands and make them shout tonight. The champions about to get down. Pick a side, pick a side. Only two options, be with the winners or the other guys. Yeah, ain't no time, ain't no time. We already on the way. Better get themselves in line. Thought I told you we don't play. The team going nuts, the score going up, morale going down, the fans packing up. Now all the kids got a new hero. They ain't never seen so many zeros. And that's when the crowd starts to shout. Yeah. You know who's up in the house tonight. The champions are back in your town.
Here we are, getting ready for this showdown between these two fighters. Should be a good one. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
About time, too.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Rocky Marciano. He's 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live. Undefeated. And he'll be taking on Muhammad Ali, 6'3" tall, the best to ever do it.
Remember, there's a shorter reach here, so now...
The Rock, Rocky Marciano, the Brockton Brawler himself, one of the greatest fighters of all time, a sparkling record, and one of the best to ever do it. The greatest, Muhammad Ali, fighting out of Louisville, Kentucky. Float like a butterfly and sting like a bee.
Just take note, Todd. Check out the reach. Check it out.
The fighters are in the ring. It's time for the official introductions. Here's the Hall of Famer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. In the red corner, here is...
To fight in this venue, you have got to be a very accomplished fighter. And I think it's safe to say that both of these athletes are certainly that. Here's the bell to start round one. They're both going for the KO. It's so obvious. Perfect counter lands. They're both going for the KO. It's so obvious. And with the right counter. Counter shot with the right hand. Who's willing to go where the other fighter won't? You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in his chest and pound away.
You fight a swarmer, you've got to protect everything. The body with the elbow, the head with the forearm. You've got to try and push them off balance because they will just stay in your face.
Halfway through the round, and man, these two are going at it. Right hook. Just as quickly as it slows down, it heats back up. Perfect counter shot. So much for boxing. This is a fight. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. No doubt about who won that round.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy.
Here we go, it's round two. The Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. This is a high-octane battle. Nice exchange here from both men. Offensive display landing in that left counter. It's obvious this fighter is gassed out. Why sit in there and throw punches? He's got to find a way to get around that reach advantage.
Very smart, very sharp. This is the fit young man style that he's got to get inside that long reach. Not many fights can do that.
Pretty close fight here in this round. Punch scores. And he fails to score with that left hook. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Seemed like eternity for them finally comes to a close.
Every second.
Let's get it started in round three. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
Can win the fight with one punch, and you can lose the fight in one punch.
Guys that carry so much power, of course they're going to look that knockout because it makes a night a little bit shorter. You don't get paid any extra for overtime.
In this fight, and both fighters have had their big moments. He just misses with that big right hand. He blocks the hook. Misses with that jab. Right when you think the pace will slow down, it picks up. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this race. At this point, you gotta believe he can't win on the scorecards, gonna need a knockout.
Needs a knockout without a doubt. Needs to go out there and think, right, you know what? Next round, you're getting it. You're gonna get a kitchen sink.
The referee calling for seconds out. Right back into the action. Back at it in round four. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him, tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Endurance is becoming a factor. You can see this fighter having a hard time getting out of the way of punches, and they're not throwing as many on their own.
What can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they hope to knock them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and relax. Because you know what you can do in the gym. You can do it in a fight. You've got to relax.
Halfway through the round, and I don't know who's got the advantage. Great stuff. Through the hook, didn't land. Missed him with that uppercut. This fighter's certainly not going to out-throw their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
I've seen certain fighters that can determine just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Well, he is in big trouble here. He may have been saved by the bell.
Wow, it was like two different...
Time for the fifth round. That corner has got to find a way to get some momentum behind their fighter.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then, put the pressure on.
He's going to keep his elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of those body shots. But come on, that leaves more opportunities for head shots. He carries that right jab away. Second win. You've got to find it somehow.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about one.
At the halfway point, and both of these fighters know the round is still up for grabs. And that hook misses. One moment changes everything, especially in this division. Change here from both men. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Moment forward, he cannot afford to lose another round.
The bell, sometimes it can be the sweetest sound.
This is the beginning of round six. Safe safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's been hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. You will fight fire with fire. Hold him up. Be smart because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are running. Your head's not clear. Be sharp.
One of the best attributes to have in boxing has nothing to do with boxing. It's how well you can take a punch to the face.
I've seen some fights with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like a crush. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. And this is the danger spot.
Waiting for this fighter to show some defensive ability. Nice punch. Nice punch. Coming back to life now, starting to land some punches. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. At this point, you gotta believe he can't win on the scorecards, gonna need a knockout.
Wow, you know what? I've been in fights like that. When you're thinking, come on, Bo, ring away.
Here we go, it's round 7. It has been all one-way traffic. How do they turn this around? Sort of the death by a thousand paper cuts approach. He'll hit you 1,000 times before you can land one.
So you're getting in there with somebody that's so fast, you're prepared to take a licking because you've got to get some before you get in close.
Both men step back for just a moment. Just gets out of the way of that right uppercut. We both know who the bigger power puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
Todd, we know one of these fights can knock you out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
A hard time finding a home with that right uppercut. He prevents that left uppercut from scoring. Fighter willing to sit down on these punches. They're arm punches. They're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. He is down big time on the scores.
Looks absolutely exhausted. What are you going to tell him in the corner?
See how they bounce back here in this round. Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
How'd you deal with an aggressive fighter? What you do is you fight fire with fire. You either give it them back because that's where they're comfortable, or you play calm, play cool.
So far, it seems like aggression has been the key. This fighter just not slowing down. Aki Marciano covering up, trying to buy some time to get out of trouble. He was in trouble for a while there. Looks like he's starting to get his power back. I thought that was going to be a knockdown at least. For those who thought this would be a mismatch, you are sorely wrong. Big shot from both of these fighters. Got to be careful, though. This fighter has tested their opponent's power and apparently isn't impressed as they continue to walk through all these power shots.
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you're gone. You've got to protect them. You've also got to get your shots off. And they forget, you can bang too.
You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place. Aki Marciano covering up, trying to buy some time to get out of trouble. Stamina is always an issue in a prize fight.
You cannot gas out if you prepared right, slept right, ate right, and did everything right for this fight. You have no excuse for gassing out.
And we enter the ninth. There's 1 minute, enough time for them to recover after what we saw last round.
What are they doing that now? What are they trying to get them ending up? They get six rounds in one. They're going to...
Aki Marciano is down!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5!
So they'll make it up and this fight continues. Step back for just a moment. Swing and a miss. It's a good start to the round for this guy. We're going to see a jab from these two. No doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
It's the one who draws first blood, Todd. That's what you've got to look at.
Are we witnessing one of the all-time greats go down? He gets out of the way of that left hand. The final 10 seconds of the round, and he is there. Aki Marciano is supposed to be the one knocking this guy out. Boy, this next round is going to be crucial considering the knockdown we just witnessed.
Can make or break a fighter.
Couldn't finish him off in the last round. Let's see what this has in store for us.
What a knockdown. You know what they're saying. When you get out there, jump on him. Do not give him chance to breathe. Bully him, throw him, push him down, punch him in the back. Keep letting the shots go because you know you want to shake your legs. Get ready, and that's it. Away from getting stopped.
See how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round. That hook doesn't find its target. When you're a power power puncher, you're not as concerned with how many punches you throw. It's about how many you land and how hard they are.
You've got to be courageous when you're getting in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain there.
We're at the halfway point, and both of these fighters know the round is still up for grabs. He misses with that jab. Back up on their feet, but I'm not sure why. Final 10 seconds here, unless we get some late drama. I think we all know who wins this round. Let's see how the game plan changes after that big knockdown.
I love the response.
And there's the bell for round 11. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not gonna happen. He's got a hustle on him. He's got a bluff.
Big left there, but misses. With that jab. So far, it seems like aggression has been the key. This fighter just not slowing.
Look at him fighting to survive. He's never.
And he goes down. Not looking good for him right now. At some point, the corner may have to intervene here because this fighter won't stay down.
Are we about to witness history? The great Rocky Marciano in serious trouble.
And he's down here. Let's see if he can beat the count. Trying to make it up before 10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You're out.
So it's onward and upward after another knockout win here.
Well, there's no argument right there. That you say it. Night-night.
The dangerous and ready for combat. Soon as I catch him on sight, it's contact. I get the job done proper, there's no comebacks. That's not fair, people hoping on the balance. But even you got that magic or you haven't. And we were born and blessed with all this talent. Soon as we get with a task, it's so apparent. I'm fully prepared, fully activated and ready. Focused on the target, grab my weapon, hold it steady. Your name, you know the name rains heavy. Got the beast in me screaming out, let me out the cage. I ain't gotta do it with rage. The days are numbered, see my steps are calculated. On time, not a second hour late. Witnessing the mastery that we display like a hitman. Yeah. See, I go in and get the job done. I got that
experience like I've been doing this for centuries. Before the events, I would practice while it was empty. Never needed approval, all I needed was improvement. Got swift.
Got high hopes for this contest with these two fighters. Should be a really good matchup. I'm Todd Grisham, and here with me, my broadcast colleague, it's Johnny Nelson.
The pleasure's always mine, my friend.
Time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. Muhammad Ali. The Gypsy King, Tyson Fury. He's so... Great matchup. Cannot wait. in the next one. Well, we know what the game plan is going to be for this fighter. He's got to stick and move and avoid the big shots from the bigger man.
Man is to try and change that game plan. Getting angry, getting frustrated, making deviate away from the plan.
Seeing as he looks to have a great point of his life. He's in trouble for a while now. Looks like he's starting to get
team.
Thank you.
complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here.
Amazing pace and tempo from the last round. significant power difference. How would you handle that?
Sometimes when you get nervous, some of them are so powerful.
Thinking, you just gotta be smart with them. You gotta be like a little favorite, a quick pass.
The I went over the rules. I want you to protect yourself.
Okay. Right. gonna do right here is settle the score. Look around you. We got a whole room full of monsters. We gonna shut it down like this. Let's go.
It's a full moon, so look out. We are live outside at Empire Fight Camp. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Hi to everybody back home.
It's time now for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali, 6'3" tall, the best to ever do it. And across the ring from him, Tyson Fury, who stands an imposing 6'9" tall, with a reach of 85 inches.
Yeah, you've got to be.
He is the greatest, Muhammad Ali. Watch the footwork, watch the hand speed. No one does it like Ali. The Gypsy.
Thank you.
Papa's read, there are no losers in this one. It's no secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter. And the corner has got a firecracker on that fight to get out there and get the job done.
Just a moment. Round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt, you've got to get out there again. Be smart, be sharp. Don't be a fool, don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him, tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
It's okay to be aggressive now. Thank you. what they wanted, but let's see what they can do in this round.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they're going to beat it. They style it out. They're on the back foot, jab, rest of the jab. Smart and pop until your legs come back. Then, put the pressure on.
In boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
Sometimes when you get nervous, someone that's so powerful, thinking you just gotta be smarter than me. You gotta be like a little favorite, big bucket.
Just missed it. They don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment. Can't believe we're only halfway through the round. In this way. Was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's been hurt. He's gonna come up, put the pressure on. He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart because he's gonna try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
Oh.
see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power. And I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
I've seen some fights with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like this. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. And this is the danger.
The first fight here in this round. You'd like to see this fighter protect themselves a little better. Punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Could it happen? Because all of a sudden he just gets himself out trying to get that shot, and that's when he catches you.
Just misses with that jab. And he misses with that jab. Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
You've got to be courageous when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain.
for just a moment. Jab doesn't find a home. They're arm punches, they're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Well, this is the time that the trainer needs to come in and say something special. This fighter needs to turn the tables in this next round. This is the 11th who's entered the championship round. It has been all one-way traffic. How do they turn this around? The old adage is, no matter how much speed you've got, timing beats speed.
Great footwork and that great hand speed. It's so hard. It's an uphill battle.
Seconds to go. Well, we're in desperation. submission mode here. Going to need a knockout.
You're absolutely exhausted. What are you going to tell him in the corner?
Continue. How do they turn things around? He blocks the uppercut. That's what it all boils down to. Who's going to have more endurance?
He's got a few fighters that are absolutely shattered. What gets you through? Willpower. Calm, because if you panic, you get desperate. You make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked out.
You're judging this fight, and both fighters have had their big moments.
Learn a big, big, hard lesson. I totally agree.